ICANN uses advanced 3D printing technology for home building, with an interest in printing habitats on the Moon and Mars. In 2018, the company marked a historic milestone by delivering the first 3D printed home in the United States to secure a building permit. Since then, ICANN has built communities of 3D printed homes in the US and Mexico, alongside barracks for service members of the US Army and Air Force. Their 3D printed buildings are energy efficient and can be made much faster than traditional methods. Typically, it prints the walls of a home in 1 to 2 days, with larger structures up to 2,000 square feet completed in 1 to 3 days. To date, the company has constructed over 180 homes and structures across the US and Mexico. Looking beyond Earth, ICANN plans to apply its expertise in large-scale 3D printing to develop sustainable habitats on the Moon and Mars. The company aims to build resilient, radiation-resistant structures to support long-term human presence on the Moon, paving the way for future missions to Mars. Project Olympus, ICANN's vision for lunar construction. Under a Phase 3 small business grant from NASA, ICANN was awarded a $60 million contract for their Project Olympus research on space-based construction systems to support exploration of the Moon. This project develops a space-based construction systems to support lunar exploration by harnessing local resources like lunar regolith to 3D print habitats, roads, landing pads, and other infrastructure. To live sustainably off-world, humanity has to learn how to build habitats and large-scale structures on other planets and moons. Building large structures is a labor-intensive and time-consuming activity on Earth. Off-world construction with limited crew in bulky astronaut suits, it becomes impractical to build habitats like we do on Earth. There has to be a better way. How Project Olympus works. ICANN outlines a clear process for lunar construction in 5 steps. 1. Arrival. The Olympus system lands on the Moon via commercial lander. 2. Deployment. The lander unloads Olympus onto the lunar surface. 3. Navigation. Olympus autonomously drives to a pre-selected build site. 4. Setup. At the site, Olympus deploys and prepares for construction. And 5. Construction. Olympus processes lunar regolith, that's moon rocks and dust, into high-strength building material, which it uses to 3D print structures. Building sustainable lunar architecture requires more than just construction. Permanent habitats must be able to withstand extreme temperature differences between the lunar day and night, harsh solar radiation with no protection from a magnetic field or atmosphere, and withstand micrometeorites and other ejecta, especially true until landing pads and roads are constructed. How lunar construction works. Building materials cannot be sent from Earth. It's too expensive. Besides, there are plenty of building materials on the Moon and Mars. They just need to be processed first into suitable conditions to be used by a 3D printer. ICANN believe they can process the lunar regolith, that's moon rocks and dust, into a super strong building material that can be used by their 3D printers. Their Olympus system can be used to not only construct habitats, but landing pads, roads, and non-pressurized structures in addition to pressurized living quarters. This technology, although designed initially for the Moon, will also work in other locations, such as Mars. The Moon is highly demanding due to the lack of atmosphere, extreme temperature swings, and high radiation, meaning that the system should work in other locations, such as Mars. How space-based construction works. As discussed already, building materials will be made from local resources. NASA is already committed to living off the land and using local resources for construction, rocket fuel, and possible life support needs, such as oxygen and water derived from lunar water ice. ICANN can convert the lunar regolith into a building material that is stronger than concrete, with the only consumable being energy, which is readily available from solar panels, or perhaps fuel cells or even micronuclear reactors. ICANN's Project Duneflow completes successful spaceflight with Blue Origin. In 2025, ICANN's Project Olympus team achieved a milestone by launching their first spacebound payload aboard Blue Origin's New Shepard rocket. Named Project Duneflow, this initiative, developed in partnership with NASA, investigates the flowability of lunar regolith and the stability of artificial slopes made from lunar surface material. Project Duneflow aims to enhance the development of lunar simulants, synthetic materials that replicate lunar regolith properties. While a small amount of actual lunar regolith has been returned to Earth, it's insufficient for routine testing, making accurate simulants critical. Understanding how lunar material behaves is essential for designing excavators and conveyance systems for moon-based construction. By studying regolith flow under simulated lunar gravity, Duneflow provides ICON and NASA with vital data to support the construction of stable, sustainable lunar infrastructure. Melody Yashar's 2022 TED Talk, Building Habitats on the Moon and Mars. Melody Yashar, a designer and architect at ICON, delivered an interesting TED Talk in 2022, sharing the company's vision for constructing habitats on the Moon and Mars. Formerly part of NASA's Ames Human Systems Integration Group, Yashar highlighted how the Artemis program will enable humanity to build on the Moon within this decade. To thrive on Mars, Yashar explained, we must create protective, durable structures to shield against solar radiation, galactic cosmic rays, extreme temperature swings, and occasional dust storms. Using local resources is critical, as crew time is valuable and best spent on scientific tasks like collecting samples and conducting experiments. Autonomous construction is essential to maximize efficiency. Teleoperating robots from Earth is impractical for Mars due to a 20-minute communications delay. While this works for NASA rovers, which move slowly and don't require rapid, precise construction, building large habitats demands a different approach. ICON proposes using autonomous robots to construct habitats layer by layer. By combining Martian regolith, that's Martian dirt, and local water with additives and binders brought from Earth, robots can produce high-performance construction material. The goal is an airtight structure capable of withstanding pressurization to one Earth atmosphere while maintaining a temperate, habitable environment. The construction process begins with robots prospecting for a suitable build site, collecting and processing raw materials, and printing foundations. As the structure rises, pre-built components from Earth, such as airlocks and life support systems, are integrated during printing. To enhance crew well-being, Yashar emphasized incorporating windows for natural light and greenery, creating a home-like environment that supports long-term habitation. ICON joins DARPA's Lunar 10 Lunar Architecture Study. In 2023, ICON was selected as one of 14 participants in the Defense Advanced Research Project Agency's, or DARPA for short, 10-year Lunar Architecture Capability Study. This seven-month initiative unites companies with critical technologies to develop a thriving lunar economy. Lunar 10 aims to create a framework for interoperable commercial lunar infrastructure, guiding research and investment over the next decade. ICON's participation connects its space and off-world R&D team with technology providers in communications, power, and mobility services. This collaboration enables ICON to align its 3D printing capabilities with the needs of the lunar economy. Evan Jensen, ICON's Vice President of Strategic R&D, stated, "Through Lunar 10, we gain insight into the availability, timing, cost, and scale of key resources. In turn, technology providers can rely on ICON's construction expertise to support their services on the moon," unquote. By contributing to Lunar 10, ICON strengthens its role in shaping sustainable lunar infrastructure. Mars Dune Alpha, ICON's 3D printed Mars habitat. While advancing lunar architecture, ICON has created Mars Dune Alpha, a 3D printed habitat for NASA located at the Johnson Space Center in Houston, Texas. Built using ICON's Vulcan construction system, this 1,700 square foot structure simulates a realistic Mars habitat to support long-duration exploration-class space missions. Mars Dune Alpha serves as the centerpiece for NASA's Crew Health and Performance Exploration Analog, or CHAPEA for short, experiment. Designed to mimic life in a future Mars surface habitat, it features 4 private crew quarters, dedicated workstations, a medical station, common lounge area, a galley, and food growing stations. The habitat's layout separates living and working spaces, optimizing functionality for crew members. 3 crews, each comprising 4 individuals and 2 alternatives, will live in Mars Dune Alpha for 1-year missions. These missions will generate critical data on NASA's space food system, as well as physical and behavioral health outcomes, informing resource planning and risk mitigation for extended Mars missions. First CHAPEA crew completes year-long Mars simulation. On the 6th of June 2024, the first crew of NASA's Crew Health and Performance Exploration Analog mission emerged from their simulated Martian habitat at the Johnson Space Center in Houston, Texas, after a 378-day mission. This milestone marks the completion of the first of three simulated missions designed to prepare for crewed Mars exploration by studying the effects of off-world living on human health and performance. The four crew members lived in 1,700 square foot 3D-printed habitat constructed by ICON, replicating conditions expected on Mars. They conducted mission objectives such as simulated Mars walks, robotic operations, habitat maintenance, exercise, and crop growth. To mirror Martian challenges, the crew faced intentional stressors, including resource limitations, isolation, confinement, and a Mars-realistic communication delay of up to 44 minutes round-trip with Earth. We meticulously planned the past 378 days to simulate challenges crews may encounter on Mars, and this crew's dedication achieved unprecedented operational goals, said CHAPEA Principal Investigator Grace Douglas. I'm eager to analyze the data, prepare for CHAPEA Mission 2, and ultimately support a human presence on Mars, unquote. Unlike other analogs, CHAPEA's high-fidelity simulation incorporates Mars-specific conditions, such as extended isolation, communication delays, and a limited food system, providing critical insights for future Mars missions, which may arrive sooner than anticipated. ICON's Lunar Innovations, Texas Space Commission Grant, and MoonBox. ICON has secured a $694,350 grant from the Texas Space Commission to develop high-fidelity lunar regolith simulants, supporting NASA's Artemis program and lunar exploration efforts. These simulants, which mimic the Moon's surface material, will aid researchers across the space community. Jason Ballard, ICON's founder and CEO, stated, "High-fidelity lunar regolith simulants are vital for advancing lunar and Artemis projects. This grant not only benefits the broader space community, but it also accelerates our Olympus system for lunar and Martian construction," unquote. To further large-scale lunar mission development, ICON is building the MoonBox, a state-of-the-art lunar regolith testing chamber. Capable of holding over 70 tons, ICON's high-quality lunar highlands simulant, the MoonBox features an environmentally controlled space equipped with stationary robots, flexible lighting, and a 6 degrees of freedom motion capture system. This facility will enhance testing and refinement of lunar construction technologies. As ICON advances its Moon and Mars habitat designs, the question remains, is 3D printing the best approach for off-world habitats, or should we rely on inflatable structures or natural lava tubes? Share your thoughts in the comments section below. Okay, that's it for this video. Thanks for watching. A quick note, Space News Live is on Saturday evening or Sunday morning, depending where you watch from. I recap the videos I posted this week, answer questions, respond to comments and chat messages, cover any missed news, and preview upcoming content. I'd love for you to join if you can. Be sure to like and subscribe so you will see our upcoming videos. We make videos every week covering the space industry, with an emphasis on the smaller space startups that aren't covered so well on other channels. See you soon!